Brittany Griner the ball on the inside more than anyone else on the team does. Like, there's no way as a professional athlete you can sit here and completely discount what team chemistry and player chemistry stands for and what that means.
None of what Chiné and Andrea said was inaccurate. And I'm going to say something to you that I have said on many, many occasions. It's not that you're wrong. It's that we don't care. Everything y'all said does not matter for this particular instance. We don't want to hear anything about Team USA. We know they won 7 straight goals. Put Andrea and Chiné up on this screen. I want to look at them this whole segment when I'm talking to them. You just highlighted 7 straight gold medals. Oh, my God. We're really worried that they're not going to get an 8th. Oh, we really worried. I mean, we got to make sure that spots 1 through 12, every single such spot that is picked. I mean, it's got to be because it's pivotal, Shannon. I don't know if you know this, Shannon. It's pivotal. I mean, they won 7 straight. They might not get 8. They might not get 8. Stop it. You know good and damn well, with or without Caitlin Clark, they gonna probably win the gold again. That's not what this conversation is about. This is about what I will personally label the idiocy of Team USA Women's Basketball. How dare you make this decision? It's stupid. And I'm gonna tell you why it's stupid. I want all the ladies on this squad to know every single one of y'all are deserving of it. Caitlin Clark does not deserve a spot ahead of any of the players on this roster, okay? If we're talking just basketball, you know we're not. You know we're not. Let's harken back to the Dream Team in 1992. Remember when Christian Laettner was on that squad? Forget the other pro players. Forget the pro players. That's a given. First time NBA players were allowed to participate. Don't put that damn screen up when I'm talking right now. I want to see Chiné and Andrea, okay? The point is this. Those rosters, right? Those players were on there. Do you know that Christian Laettner also was chosen ahead of Shaquille O'Neal and Alonzo Mourning? You know why? He was a 2-time national champion. He was a Wooden Award winner. And he was white. And he had his own cachet. He brought it to the table. He was a big-time collegiate player who was white and busting people's you-know-what. They couldn't miss, and they didn't need him. You had Jordan. You had Magic. You had everybody, and you still picked that dude. Why? It wasn't because of basketball, even though he had the basketball credentials. It was because of something else, and they didn't need the pub. But the WNBA does. You got a max salary at $250,000. You had attendance, although it was trending in the right direction, certainly wasn't where you wanted it to be. And as Shannon pointed out just the other day, you got a team in the Indiana Fever with their struggling selves, struggling to win a damn game and be relevant. No team in the WNBA was worse other than the winless Washington Mystics, okay? And they went from 4,000 in attendance to 17,000. This girl is box office. I said a rising tide lifts all boats. What you do, especially if you're Team USA and you're trying to be globalized, it is an opportunity to globalize the WNBA brand. So people like Brittany Griner, you know, God bless her soul, and others don't have to go to Russia in the offseason to play additional basketball to get extra income. They could stay right here. If the sport elevates its popularity and you ladies start getting what you richly deserve, I'll even get a bit personal to Chiné Agumake and Andrea Carter. I recognize the fact that y'all are outstanding basketball analysts. You know how I feel about both of y'all. I told you privately. I've told the world publicly. I think y'all are a tag team for the ages. I think y'all are spectacular. But as spectacular as you are about talking the game of basketball, is that why you think I call for you to be on First Take? It ain't just because of your expertise. It's because you're great television. You matter. You draw an audience. This man, I don't even call Shannon Shannon anymore unless I'm teasing him about the Saturday Night Live skit. It's the truth, Shannon. That's the only time I call him Shannon. You know what I call him now? I call him Shay. Or Shay Shay. Why? Because damn it, that brand is growing. You understand what this man has done to help Lift First Take? I ain't apologizing. You make decisions, marketing. I want people watching. I want eyeballs. I want advertising dollars. Why? Because he'll get paid. Y'all will get paid. And guess who else will get paid? You see where I'm coming from? That's what it's about. Stop acting otherwise. We know this. You don't sit up there and pass on Caitlin Clark. It was stupid, team. Team USA, it was a dumb decision. Everybody, there's always somebody that's a sacrificial lamb. I respect the hell out of Rebecca Lobo and what she broke down. I understand it. It was a stupid decision because it compromises what your ultimate goal is, which is to elevate the WNBA brand. How can you be that idiot? I'm not talking about y'all. I'm talking about Team USA. How could you be that idiotic and not make that call when throughout history, Team USA has been in part about marketing? It's dumb. Period.